Hey, everyone, and welcome to General Hospital Uncensored, the radio show. I'm your host, Kimberly Weller, and I'm accompanied by my co-host, the greatest, Cheryl.
Hi, guys. How are y'all today?
So I hope everybody had a great Thanksgiving. I know I did. I ate a little bit too much. Still eating leftovers. But, yeah, we don't have much to cover this week. We have 3 days of episodes to cover, but they were pretty juicy, so I think we're going to have a good time tonight. What do you think, Cheryl?
I think we're going to have a great time tonight.
Okay. All right. Let me finish chewing my fish stick, and we will get started. Okay. Paula. Is Paula new? I don't recognize that name.
I think she was here last time.
Okay. Well, welcome back, Paula, if you weren't here last time. Let me remind you guys, if you guys plan on participating in a show, you can always just be in the chat and talk through the chat to us. That's fine. We still acknowledge you guys there. But if you want to call in and join into the show and participate and give your feedback on the topics we talk about, please call in now, and we'll always be able to pull you in and out of the conversation. So please dial the number below, which is 1-724-444-7444, and you'll enter our show call ID, which is 135-722-pound, and then you'll enter your PIN. Your PIN will be the number that you signed up with. If you have a problem with that number, you're just going to press one and then pound, and that'll bypass that whole PIN annoying thing, and you'll be able to just still call in and join. So we hope you guys do decide to join in today. We love hearing from you. And I know people get tired of hearing just me and Cheryl. Right, Cheryl?
Right. We're totally boring.
Actually, I'll say we're not boring at all. So
we're not boring, yeah. We're not.
Not at all. We're just very juicy. Okay, so let me see. Let me pull up my thing. I had to restart my computer. I forgot I had to get that. Let me start off by saying welcome to the show. Again, I'm Kimberly, and Cheryl is the co-host here. And we bring the show to you every Wednesday and Saturday. On Wednesday, it's 9 p.m. On Saturday, it's 10 p.m. And we're only doing the Wednesday shows through the November sweep, which should be wrapping up pretty soon, right?
Yeah. sweeps? Yeah, I think sweeps is over now.
It's over?
Yeah.
Huh.
I mean, it was just for the month of November.
Yeah, and today's the 29th, so that makes sense. So I wonder, should we continue our Wednesday shows or should we just continue them?
Well, I don't know. I guess it would depend on, you know, what's going on, because right now they're about to get elbow deep in the flick storyline,
mm-hmm.
and we're about to get and then, of course, Jason's supposed to remember who he is right around Christmas time, from what
True.
I hear. Robin's coming back, and that'll be a lot to talk about. So
there are sweeps in February. Paula said wrapping up just in time for February sweeps. So they'll pick back up all the juiciness in February.
Yeah.
There are several major storylines going on still, though, even though it's not
February
sweep.
Yeah, wrapping up the stuff. I didn't know there was a February sweep. Maybe they do them every 4 months.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay. So I guess we'll still, you know, we'll bring you guys the Wednesday shows, and we'll just play it by ear, you know. For now, we'll just say that Wednesday shows are still going to happen. And as always, you know, if holidays are in the way, we won't do it. Like, we didn't do this past Wednesday because the next day was Thanksgiving, and, you know, a lot of people are with their families and cooking and all that stuff. So we'll just go ahead and keep doing the Wednesday sweeps. And I know, Phyllis, you want us to stay every day. Monday through Friday, right? So we'll go ahead and we'll continue the sweeps. But as always, if we don't get a big crowd, we'll cancel it for that. We'll do the sweeps. I mean, we'll do Wednesday shows. If we don't get many people on Wednesdays, we'll just discontinue the show to the following show, which is always on Saturdays. We always do Saturdays no matter what. unless something really comes up. But for the most part, we really try to make Saturdays always happen. So Wednesdays is kind of up in the air because it's during the work week. Some people got school, some people got work the next day, and some people turn in for the night really early, which I'm not one of those people. So sometimes it's not as convenient for people to tune into the Wednesday shows, but we still try. So look for us on Wednesdays. If we're not doing a Wednesday show, we'll definitely let you guys know in the group. Okay? Also, let me say I want to give a shout-out to our other admins who are the greatest. We have Cheryl right here with me, of course. We have Judith. We have Deborah. We have Anna and Maggie, who are all excellent admins, and I want to give them their props because you guys have no idea what we deal with. You see it in the group for the most part. You see you guys catch bits and pieces of the things we have to deal with. But for the most part, you know, there's a lot more than you guys probably even see because we get to it so quick that you guys probably don't even notice how much stuff really happens in the group. But I want to give them a shout out because, as always, they're right on top of things and handle things in a very mature, you know, manner where things just get taken care of without all the bull crap, you know. A lot of people and, you know, tend to try to be messy and cause problems and stir up drama. And, you know, that might be because they come from other groups who are okay with that kind of stuff. Or, you know, they might feel the need to be defensive all the time because they always have to be in other groups. But, you know, we try to really keep General Hospital Uncensored, the Facebook group, for those of you who don't know what General Hospital Uncensored is, if you're listening on YouTube. We try to keep it really, you know, cool and calm and I personally want to be a chick that you wouldn't mind hanging out with. And I know Cheryl the same way as well. We know we just want to be a big group of 15,000 friends who talk about General Hospital, you know,
we
without...
We just hit 15,000, Kimberly. I can't
believe that. Yeah, actually we did. We hit 15,000 members the day before yesterday. We're so excited. This is in probably about 8 months now. We've hit 15,000 members, so we're well on our way. We're doing great. And it's all because you guys are really supportive and active in the group, and it's a great thing. So thank you guys all for being, you know, part of the group and supporting us in all of our little ventures that we do. But, yeah, back to that. So I do want to touch on a couple things, and Cheryl as well. We wanted to just bring up how we brought this up before, but, you know, it seems like this conversation can never get old because it always reoccurs over and over again. But, you know, we just want to remind you that the characters on General Hospital are definitely just characters, and anything said about them is purely about the character, and it's all in good fun, and it's nothing for you to take personally or to heart. And if you really feel like you cannot handle negative feedback on the characters, then I really would suggest that you might want to find a group that might fit your style a little bit better, because we do that here. That's what we're here for. I should be able to talk about Liz and call her a hoe, and you say, Kim, that's not nice. I like Liz, you know, LOL, you know, and laugh it off and just have fun with it. It's not that serious. Let's have fun, you guys. Let's not ruin the vibe of the group. It feels like we have sometimes a few people who come in here deliberately, and it's always the new people, the really new people, like a couple days old, who come in and it seems like they want to just stir things up, and, you know, we try to get on it really quick. But we just want to remind you guys, if you see these things going on and you hear people bad-mouthing General Hospital Uncensored, I just say just sit back and watch how we work for a few months and then make your decision on how you feel about how we do things. Don't come in brand new and judge us. Watch things for a little bit and see, and then I guarantee you'll be happy with this group like we all are. Do you have anything you want to say?
Yes, I was going to say that please, if you guys see something that, you know, like somebody is posting, you know, and being rude and condescending and belittling other people, please message one of the admins, because, you know, sometimes, you know, there might be an hour during the day where all of us admins are busy with our real lives. You know, and you may catch it. So, you know, please, 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 please message us and let us know so that we can jump on it. Because I have so many people who, you know, are complaining, well, you got on Facebook, but you didn't get on Twitter. I was like, well, you know, I or, you know, I didn't catch it in time, you know, it's long past. And now I see people say this stuff all the time, and I'm like, well, I can't address it if you don't tell me about it.
Exactly.
So if you see something or have a situation or you feel attacked by another member, do not engage with that member. And please come find an admin. We will deal with it. We're all seasoned warriors when it comes to trolls and bitchy bitches and all that stuff. So,
and we're usually not that far away. You know, if you, it won't be long. I mean, within the half hour, you should hear back from somebody, you know, if you alert us. Or even if you, there's an option on there. What is it that they can notify an admin or alert an admin or something like that? What is report to an admin? Yeah.
Yeah, something like that. I could not message one of you the other day. I tried several times. One was when someone got on and said, get over it. Okay, well, at this moment in time, it's kind of over with and, you know, done and moved on. But, you know, as for if you were looking for the admin's name and you don't know who the admins are, you can go to the pinned post, and all of our names are in there.
Mm-hmm, where the
and,
rules are.
Yeah. And I don't know, maybe we should talk to Judith when she posts it. Maybe she should tag all of the admins in, like, with it, so that way they're easy for people to click on, you know, one of our names. Maybe that would help.
In the description and above the picture, that would be smart.
Yeah. And just tag all of our names, so that way, you know, all they got to do is scroll up and click on one of our names.
Yeah.
So maybe that'll make it easier for people to find.
Report to an admin is in the corner. I believe there's a little arrow on the side, and it'll give you options like report to admin, and like block or stop notifications. And then there should be a option for you to report to an admin. Don't report it. Report to an admin, because if you report it, it goes to Facebook, not us.
Yeah, this kind of gives us a little bit of an alert to, so that we need to kind of look into the situation and see what's going on and discuss amongst us, the admins, on how to best deal with it. Because we're always in contact with each other. We always are talking to each other all day long, every day. So, you know, we're always communicating with each other.
Exactly.
So,
anything that's going on in a group, even if you see only one of us addressing it in the group, all of us are definitely aware of what's going on, because we do let each other know as things happen, so that we all know what's going on at all times in a group. So we communicate really well that way. So if you, if you hit one admin up and we're not able to get to it, we'll definitely let another admin know what's going on and that is available, and they'll jump on it.
Yeah. And, we're very good about making sure that everyone's aware. We have our ways of communicating with each other on a max level. So, whenever we get, like, a PM that we can't quite get to yet, or, you know, I think a lot of things that people don't realize let me take that back. Okay. When you email an admin or when you message an admin or whatever, make sure you tag us in the group and let us know that you sent us a message. Because sometimes, a lot, if you're not my friend, it's going to end up in my other folder. And I check that other folder maybe once a week, if that. So, if you message me, I usually don't check it unless I have a reason to check it. So please, if you do, go to the pinned post or something and post in there and say, hey, Cheryl, I sent you a message. Can you check your other folder and tag me? And I'll check it and then I'll talk to you.
Mm-hmm.
Or I think it would be the same for everybody else, Maggie, Anna, anybody else. So, if you have a problem and you want to message us. But go to the pinned post or just make a post in the group and tag us and be like, hey, I sent you a message. So that way we know that it's in our other box so that we can get to it in a timely manner.
Mm-hmm. A certain somebody, I'll tell you about it later, because I'm looking at the Liz post. The Liz post is what kind of got us started on this topic, because it always tends to get people heated. People really feel like, Liz is their BFF for life, and, you better not talk about my Liz. And they really get offensive, offended and defensive about anything that has to do with Liz. And sometimes I feel like people almost do it purposely to try to get a rise from us, but we're not going to fall down that track. So if you're trying it, you know, you might as well just stop, because we don't get shook up too easy. And, you know, it's just not that serious. You know, we'd rather remove you than go back and forth with you. So you're really not going to get anywhere with trying to taunt us. Okay?
Mm, exactly. Like, you know, causing drama does nothing. We'll delete the post and we'll either message you or ban you from the group, because, you know, it really just depends on the severity of the situation. But I don't want
people to think that we are like boot heavy. We're not boot heavy at all. You know, but if it is, instead of going back and forth to people, and also, you know, if you see somebody removed from the group, you guys, please know this is not something that we decide right off the bat that we're going to get rid of them. Usually we communicate with each other, and we know, and we're watching that person, and we're saying, okay, this person is kind of like a red flag. This is not the first time they've done this. Let's keep an eye on them. So before we boot them, we actually do give them a lot of chances before we remove them. We do a 3-strike, you're out rule. So if you see anybody removed, it's not because we're just completely just boot crazy and we just are power hungry and we just want to just boot people. We really try to give people a fair chance. We hit them up privately and we say, hey, you know, we don't like when people do this. We want to, you know, everybody kind of get along. Please don't talk bad to your fellow group members. And then, you know, usually people are like, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't know. Okay, and they correct it. Some people, they just don't do that so well. They just keep going. So, you know, those people we keep an eye on. And then after so many times, we boot them. So it's not like if you see their name grayed out that we just, you know, said, oh, you know what, I don't like your attitude, I'm kicking you out. More than likely, we've been watching them the whole time.
Mm-hmm. I would say I think this is like the general procedure that how we respond to things. Your first strike is pretty much your basic chastisement post where we'll tag you and we'll say, hey, that's not cool. You know, we don't do that type of thing. Please stop. And then if it goes beyond that, then we will message you and we'll hash it out in PM. And if if the behavior is not corrected, or you know, things, we can't come to a good conclusion and, you know, work things out, then that's when the event team will discuss a potential, you know, dismemberment from the group, I guess. So I think that's pretty much how we do it, right, Kim?
Yeah, that's it. So we do, you know, we're letting you guys know that. So you just know that we're not just, like, power hungry and we're just booting people like crazy.
Mm-hmm.
We really put thought behind our choices when we remove people in the group. It's not something that we just up and, you know, well, I'm guilty of it maybe once or twice, you know, but it's that time of month, so I have an excuse. But, yeah, but any other time, it's just, you know, purely because, you know, we really thought it over and we don't feel like they're a good fit for our group. We know the kind of dynamic of people that we want in a group, the kind of vibe that we want to feel when we talk to people, and the kind of people we want surrounding us, which would be the same in real life. I don't want negative people around me who are just going to bring me down. I'd rather have people around me who are cool, fun. You know, everybody has different personalities. We have our cuckoo crazies. We have our funny jokesters. We have our sugary nipples guy. You know, we have everybody, all kinds of different people, and we love them all the same. But as far as negativity, we're not trying to do that in the group. So we just ask everybody to just respect each other and have fun.
Exactly.
Okay. All right. So let me just run down through what you guys need to know about General Hospital Uncensored really quick, like always, so you guys know. As always, we do record these shows, so they will be on YouTube as well as on the homepage of this talk show. So you'll be able to catch this again later. Probably tomorrow, to review if you wanted to hear it again. Also, like I said, they're up posted on YouTube. You have to go on there and check them out. And also, you know, we have our Best of General Hospital videos on there, General Hospital Uncensored videos there as well. But you can also please add us on Twitter. Follow us on Twitter. I'm sorry, you don't add. You follow. On Twitter is GH_Uncensored. We have Deb, who does live. Has she still been doing that? Cheryl.
Oh gosh, I spaced out for a minute. What were you that?
There was like a whole 5 minute break in between that. I said, is Deb still doing the live feeds during the show?
Yes, she does it on Twitter.
Okay, because I haven't seen her really much in our little personal space, so I didn't know if she was still doing it. But yeah, Monday through Friday, if the show's airing, of course, Deb does live tweets during the show. She's hilarious. She interacts with the cast as well as even the writers and everything, and it's a lot of fun. So I would definitely check that out if you guys have a Twitter. It's GH_uncensored. Please also, if you guys see our fundraiser in the group, we're trying to move this radio show to a better location that we can be proud of, because this is just, like I said, it's free, it's low budget, but it works for now. But we're really trying to do the legit thing, so we're trying to make our fundraiser successful, where we've reached 34% of our goal, which is $430. We've got $145, which is 34%. So we just need people to support us a little bit more. $5 even will be a great deal to us, and it will really go a long ways and bring us closer to our goal. So we do ask you, if you see our fundraiser in the group, please support it. Also, please like our other page when you see that as well. Okay, so let's see. I feel like I missed something, but I think we'll be all right. Let's see. Follow-up, past recordings. Oh, yeah, and we did mention we hit 15,000 members the other day, guys. I want to bring that up again because we're really proud. It's halfway from where we need to be. We need 30,000. That's great. I don't think it's unreasonable either. The more people we get, it seems like the more ads we get a day. So I think it's not far-fetched at all.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So let's go ahead and start with this week's shenanigans. There's only 3 days that we have to follow, but a lot's gone on, so we can definitely get started. I'm going to let Cheryl start off with the whole Faison situation. Faison.
Faison is first on the list, but you're talking about Fluke.
Oh, Fluke. I'm thinking of them being the same person. Okay, so we can talk about, you know what? Let's move Faison down to where we talk about Windermere and all that, because, you know, he shows up there. So we'll talk about that down there. So let's just go start with straight with Elizabeth's house and the whole, you know, dinner and Jake and all that stuff.
Okay. All right. Well, so as you guys know, Jake or Jason is living with Elizabeth now. She gave him a place to stay since he had nowhere to go, and Dr. O kicked him out of the hospital. And so he's going around doing stuff in the house, and she's having a big Thanksgiving dinner, and she invites Patrick and Emma, obviously, because Emma and Cam are like little boyfriend and girlfriend. And then Patrick invites Sam, and obviously he asks if it's okay to bring her. He calls her and all that stuff, and Liz is okay with it, you know. And so she comes, and all of a sudden, while they're all driving, she's making dinner, and Sam and Patrick are kind of debating on whether Sam should go or not. Helena actually shows up at Elizabeth's doorstep, and I'm not really sure what her intentions were for being there, other than, you know, I guess, I think maybe she wanted to, you know, further her plans some more for Jason, but he got really skittish around her and, you know, kind of worked her out of there, and he said he was going to go get Elizabeth, and she took off, of course. And then finally, Sam and Patrick show up, and then you see Jake interacting with Danny, or Jason interacting with Danny, you know, the father and son, but they don't know that. Danny feels a connection to Jason. It's pretty obvious. And then, of course, there's Sam, who kind of just keeps looking at, you know, Jake like there's something familiar about him. She doesn't quite know exactly why she feels this you know, it's like the look you get when you get deja vu. You're like something, you feel like you've met this person or you've been in this place, but you can't remember who they are or where you've seen them or when you've been to this particular place. So it seems like that's the feeling that she's getting when she's talking to to Jake and watching him interact with Danny. Some people choose to believe that she's looking at him all in heat. I don't think so. I think that she is just genuinely curious about why she feels like she knows him.
Yeah, she looks kind of like something is just hitting her about him. And it's familiar, and it's just bothering her. She probably can't place what her emotions are, but it's there. And yeah, I don't think it's googly eyes. That's more like what Elizabeth does. But you know, I think she's just kind of like, you know, this is my husband. She doesn't know that, but she's feeling that.
Yeah, she feels a connection because, you know, obviously Jason and Sam had an emotional connection. They were in love, and they were married, and they had a child together, and so they'll always be connected. And so now that, you know, she thinks Jason's dead and Jason doesn't remember who he is, so it's like there's something familiar and, you know, about being around him, and she can't quite place why and who he is, you know, and she doesn't quite understand exactly why she feels the way she feels. And she's just getting this look, and she looks like she's just sat back and watching and looking at him like, who is this person? I feel like I know him.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. It was cute seeing him interact with little Danny and stuff. And, you know, and it's just crazy how he's not, you know, feeling something, you know, like I can understand, you know, feeling about your spouse, you know, feeling something, but with your kid, I would feel like it would be something totally different that you would definitely feel something, but he's just not seeming to, you know, connect anything quite yet with that. But as far as Elizabeth, you know, Elizabeth bought him a shirt and he kind of was like no, and I thought that was funny because she was just kind of, you know, trying to play house really desperately with him, and he's just kind of, you know, he's just kind of going with the flow. And yeah, I mean, as I said before, you know, I'm bought into the whole Billy Miller playing Jason now. I don't even think twice about the old Jason anymore. Steve Burton. I don't think about him anymore. I think he's doing a good job, and I'm anxious to see when everybody connect the dots. So that'll be good. But yeah, something's going to click soon. And I think whatever she's feeling is kind of like, you know how, like, old couples, how they say, like, with, like, old couples who've been married, like, years and years and years, you know, if one dies, then the other one usually dies not far after them. You know, they have that connection, you know, it's, like, spiritual, it's emotional. I think it's just like that, you know, she knows that there's just something, you know, that's, you know, just drawing her to him. So, yeah, I'm anxious to see where this goes.
I guess 11. Yeah, I agree. I think that, you know, I don't know. I don't know how I feel about this Liz situation. I do feel like she's kind of, you know, I think she, you know, obviously things didn't work out with Nicholas. And I think, you know, both AJ and Rick died. So, you know, and she, I think she wants to try and find love again. And she has met this guy that she feels totally comfortable with. And she really likes him. He's really good looking.
But Cheryl, this is nothing new. This is the regular. This is what she does with every man that crosses her path. So it's not like it's a different scenario. It's a different man,
well,
same
the
scenario.
The thing about this is that she doesn't know that he's Jason, obviously.
Yeah.
But if he was
Billy Bob Thornton that came in, you know, it would have been the same story, you know, even if he wasn't Jason. She's not connected to him because it's Jason like Sam is. She's just connected to him because he's another man she hasn't fucked in Port Charles. That's what she's connected to.
Well, yeah, understandable. Obviously not the biggest Liz fan, but I can see where she's coming from. You know, she's been single for quite a while, and she's tried to
not
have
really.
A couple
she was just with she was just with Rick. You know, she
yeah,
was ready for love.
Very long. They weren't together very long, and then he got quote unquote
supposedly
murdered.
Died.
Yeah, and so that didn't really have a chance to develop. And of course, the whole thing with AJ happened. So she hasn't had a really successful relationship in a really long time. So I get where she, you know, she's just ready to start out with somebody she thinks or she thinks is not someone she's ever met before. So she's like, oh, I'm starting over new and I'm getting to know this new person. And, you know, and he's really cute and I feel really comfortable hanging out and talking to him. So, you know, and I really want to help him. And, you know, I can see where she's coming from as far as that goes.
Mm-hmm.
But we all know it's Jason. So we're like, back off.
That's not even why. It's just because she's so thirsty. And if you don't know what the definition of thirsty is, let me break it down to you. Thirsty is just like desperate and just, you know, panting over every man that walks by. Thirsty is just like desperate is the best word I can describe with it. But yeah, that's what she is. And you know, and let me put this out here real quick, just in case somebody hears who's a Liz fan, and you know, they're like, oh, those admins, no wonder. No wonder they don't agree with what I say about Liz. They're Liz haters. And what did somebody say earlier? They really accused us of being, like, on our own. Like, we delete posts because they're not agreeing with what – because we don't agree with what they're saying. We delete their posts. That's not true. We only delete posts if it's being rude or you're being unnecessarily just, like, catty or you know,
if it's a repeat
condescending.
Post. Yeah, if it's a repeat post. Or if it's something personal or, you know, and we talk about, you know, things. And if there's posts that are kind of borderline, we're not sure about, we'll talk about them amongst yourselves and kind of decide whether it needs to go or not. But
right.
Nine times, you know, if it, and stuff like that.
It's never one person's decision within the admins. There's six of us and, or is it five of us? Well, there's enough of us and there's, and it's never one of our decisions to remove stuff. We always kind of run it by each other, and we do a whole, what do you think? Should we remove this? Unless it's something that clearly needs to be removed, like a personal post about, oh, the weather was so nice today, I can't wait to watch General Hospital. That's just too personal. We don't care. Sorry. Love you guys. But that's just too much information right now. You know, we're here to talk about the show. We don't. This isn't, you know, one-liner posts like you do on your normal Facebook page. This is all General Hospital stuff. This is just, you know, to get in topics that are going to start good conversations, basically, you know, are what we're looking for. But as far as us only jumping on the bandwagon of the people who we agree with, their views, that's not true at all. Because like I said earlier in the group, we're fans first and then we're admins second. We made the group for a place for us to talk about General Hospital as well. It's not just because we want to run around and, you know, police people. You know, we want to talk about General Hospital too. So if everybody had the same opinion, it would be no fun. There's no point of us being here. So we definitely want to hear your opinions, even if we don't agree with them. I hate Liz, but if you love Liz, more power to you. I'm not going to block you and down you because you love Liz. That's your problem, you know. It's not your problem, but that's your opinion, you know.
Also,
so please.
Yeah, also keep in mind that just because someone is disagreeing with you does not mean that they're attacking you.
Right.
Yeah, attacking would be like, oh, you're being such a bitch. Stop, you know.
You're a bitch for talking about Liz. You know, that is attacking, you know. If I say, oh, Cheryl, I don't like, you know, you like Liz. I can't believe you don't like Liz. I can't believe you like Liz. I hate Liz, girl. You know, that's not me attacking you. It's just me telling you I don't agree with you, but it is what it is, you know. So, yeah, just calm down, guys. But, yeah, that just brings me to the whole Liz thing because, you know, I can get carried away with how much I don't like her. But, you know, just know that we're not trying to at all remove your post for not agreeing with us. We all of us admins have different opinions on different characters anyway. So we're not all on the same page. So it's not like we're all a Liz-hating group of admins. Doesn't Deb love Liz, I think?
Yeah, she
Anna doesn't hate her. She's not a fan, but she doesn't hate her, you know, or anything like that. I mean, she's
I think Judith said. I think Judith said she like she wasn't like obviously she's not our biggest fan, but
right,
you know,
we all have different views on the characters. So you know, this isn't. If that was the case, we would have a group that was just I hate Liz group, you know, and then we would do that. You know, this is we're more than happy to hear everybody's individual opinions. Okay, so let's go back to the little itinerary we have. Let's see.
Yes.
Steve, are you having problems? Steve, are you still not able to hear us? He said he's been having audio problems and he's sighing now, so I think he's not able to get in. Hey, hey, Keith, welcome back. All right, welcome guest 12 and 11. Karen is guest 11. Hey, Karen. Yeah, let me remind you guys, call in now. Terry, let me pull her in on a conversation because I know she's on her prepaid. Hey, Terry. Terry, you are live.
Hi.
Hi, Terry. How are you?
How are you?
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving. Did you eat pizza? I'm just kidding.
Huh?
Pizza. Quarter of it wasn't very funny.
It's okay. So did you want to talk about anything we've talked about so far? We talk about the first storyline, which was about Liz and, you know, everything that's going on in her house for Thanksgiving.
You know how I feel about Liz, though.
Uh-huh.
what I was wanting to talk about was Jason and with Liz and Sam. You know, and Danny, you know, recognizes something about him. But what I don't understand is, why don't they recognize his voice and recognize and see his eyes?
I know why, because it's General Hospital.
Right. Good point.
That's what I think of. And look, and this is my mom. My mom, she's a pervert like me. She said, okay, so when he goes to have sex with Sam or he goes to have sex with Elizabeth or whoever he ends up sleeping with, like she's not going to know his junk. You know, his penis. You know,
that's,
you know
what.
True,
it's true.
You know, especially Sam. Come on now. You should know that man's penis up and down. Okay? So, like, stuff like that. Eyeballs you can't change. Well, you can change eyeballs apparently now because T.I.'s wife, she changed her eyeballs. But you can change, you know, you can't change voices. I mean, you can. I know he had voice problems when he first came out of that place. So I don't know, maybe his voice never went back to normal, but they never, of course, addressed that to us. I mean, things like eyeballs and, you know, teeth, you know, and, you know, stuff like that. When he took his shirt off, she didn't recognize his body. You've been with this man before. You didn't recognize his chest. So
yeah, really.
I don't know.
I just think that part is crazy, you know.
I guess we're just supposed to ignore that and act like, you know.
Yeah, really.
Like, okay. They're like, okay, you guys have been watching long enough. You already know we can't do all that.
Right. But it's strange that his son he was a baby.
Kelly said apparently Liz didn't do the nursing assessment on him, bullet holes and other anatomy. I guess not.
Liz, never mind. Don't get me started on Liz. But yeah.
He said, "Is it so unusual not to recognize the body of someone that you've slept with?" I don't know. I mean, the body, maybe not his chest, but his. I would really honestly.
How many
years?
For years, Liz is supposedly supposed to be in love with him, but I think she's just in heat all the time.
Well, they've had sex, obviously, numerous times, you know.
Right,
they even made a kid together.
Right. But I think if... I think hopefully if he took his shirt off in front of Sam, she would know it. She was with him a lot longer than Liz.
I would say the penis would be more defining than the chest. That's just me, though. I think that the... I don't know. That's just me, but Steve says, is it so unusual not to recognize the body of someone that you slept with? I mean, if you've slept with a lot. True, Elizabeth has been with a lot of men, so she probably won't recognize him.
Yeah, that's true. Well, Sam's a slut, too.
Sam, yeah. Let's see, I will definitely say Sam's a slut, too, you know. It's not all about just Liz.
Right. I mean, Carly's a slut, too. What the hell?
Steve
you know.
Said he never forgets a penis. I believe that. I mean, seriously, if
I
you
don't
look...
either, Steve. The darker the berry, the sweeter.
Oh, Terry.
She's about to break it down, okay?
Well, why not? I'm 50 years old.
I mean, like, seriously, and, you know, this is an uncensored show. This show is rated R, so we can talk how we want to. You know, the truth of the matter is, and I'm going to get dirty with it, if you've been with a man and you've looked at his junk, and if it curves to the left, you know that. If it's a little bit...
Well,
you know it, okay?
Yeah, you know, neither one of them has seen. Well, Liz probably did. She probably gave him a sponge bath and drilled over it. But...
Oh, Dorothy.
She
purposely drooled on it.
She volunteered. I'll do it.
She's like, oops, I drooled on it. Oops. Let me get
there
that up for you.
I'm terrible.
Why do you guys do this to me every show? We go left field on the conversations. You guys are so nasty.
Talking about,
well, you know,
we're all perverts.
Well, I'm glad I'm not alone. It makes me feel so much better when you guys chime in because I say things and... Could you imagine if it was me on the show by myself without a co-host and nobody calling in and me talking like that? I would be feeling so awkward, like, am I alone feeling like this? You know?
You are not alone.
Well,
like, Kim, you almost think Michael Jackson for you, you know?
I began my day talking about Kelly Monaco's boobs, and I'm going to end my night talking about Billy Miller's penis.
Who said that? You?
I did, Carol.
I didn't say that's natural.
Kelly,
Kelly
Monaco does have great boobs, though. Like, her boobs, for her being so tiny, they're still, like, proportionate in some weird way. They're
makes
great.
She's sick. She's pretty.
She's too skinny, though. Ooh. I'd rather have Carly's body than her body, though. She's too tiny. She's so tiny.
Yeah.
She weighs, literally, I think she weighs, like, 95 pounds.
She's
100
really
pounds.
Tiny.
Yeah.
Now, of course, Elizabeth is even tinier than her. She's super tiny. Like, she has a 12-year-old boy's body. But Kelly, I mean, she's small, too. Like, I'd be looking at her like, do you have a butt?
Rebecca is a very pretty woman.
She's gorgeous. She is.
Yeah.
As
an actress, she's awesome. You know, she's a good actress.
Yeah, let me say that. I do like Elizabeth. Is it Hurst or Herbst? Hurst. I like her a lot. She's a good actress. She's beautiful. I think she could play Jackie O in a movie very easily. She's
beautiful.
Really pretty. You know, the character of Liz, they wrote her for us to hate her, period. You know, they know what they're doing. So
Yeah.
Phyllis, is this sex ed? Are you offended, Phyllis? Are we embarrassing you?
Oh, wow.
Steve, if I were a girl, I'd want Sam's body digitally. Okay, now, let me see. Out of all characters, seriously, whose body I would want Britt's body. Britt has a banging ass, and her body is on point. Like, have you seen her on her Twitter? Her body is, like, sickening. Like, she's got a great body. Kelly
just
doesn't really have a woman's
really
body
does.
Besides her boobs.
She's a very... She's got, like, a very athletic body. Like, she looks like she
worked out,
yeah. And,
and plays baseball, too, or something as well.
Y'all talking about what body you'd want. I'm thinking of a different aspect of that, totally different. A body I would want Sean's body.
Oh,
I don't.
We know you want Sean's body all over you.
You're addicted to the chocolate.
I don't know. I need to shut up.
All right, Terry.
You're laughing at me.
That's your cue, Terry. Okay, we'll call on you later.
All right. Bye-bye.
Terry always makes sure to get in her little black men comments, don't she? I need to hook her up. I'm gonna get her in a black men for mature white women's group on Facebook, all for Terry. Okay, so let's see. Now let's see everybody's who's their bodies they'd say they'd have. Keith said, "I love Sam, but I'd want Carly's body. I think she's built like a brick house." I agree. Carly has a body a black man would love. She's a little bit thick. She's got a butt on her. She's got hips and thighs, and she's got boobs, but she's not fat, you know. She looks like she might wear a little bit of Spanx, you know, to hold a little bit in. But, you know, guys don't like bones. Dogs don't like bones.
Yeah. And I feel like it's the same thing with Britt. Like, Britt got, you know, Kelly Thibault, but she's got this athletic fit body, you know.
Yeah.
But
she definitely has, like, hips and a butt, too, though.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. And she always looks really good in, like, you know, her little dresses that she wears, her little maxi dresses that she wears, and she's got this little boho style going on, because her and Brian go to, like, concerts all the time, and it's pretty cool. I like her. I follow her on Instagram, and I follow Brian on Instagram, and they're so cute, and they seem like they have so much fun. And obviously great sex, because that's what Kim told me not too long ago, that she thinks they have great sex.
That what? What did you say? I said what?
That Brian and Kelly have great sex.
They definitely have. I swear I would love to be a fly on the wall of their sex. I guarantee
Ew.
It. And I guarantee she probably turns him out. I guarantee it. I bet you it's not him so much. I bet you it's her. I bet she probably rocks his world. That's exactly why he's with her. But let me say, now, Kelly, well, Britt, the other day when she had that red dress on the Thanksgiving, when she was telling her mom, come on and join her, and they were getting ready to go off to dinner or whatever, that dress, like, it's ridiculous. The dress wasn't even fitted or nothing. Her body is banging through something that's just as simple as that. So it's like, ridiculous.
Yeah, like, I don't know. They need to dress her better, because I swear to God, they've been putting her in, like, T-shirts and all this time. And I'm like, she's a doctor.
Yeah.
Dress her like a doctor.
Right.
Like, you know, I
don't
know.
They dress her like a college student.
Yeah, they pretty much do. Like, she looks like a college student who just got done, like, staying up half the night partying and then studying. Partying while studying.
These comments. Phyllis said, hell no, you would have to be really, where is it? Phyllis said, hey, I'm a chick. I do Sam and Carly anytime. Both of them are my crush. Keith said, I love Sam, but I'd want Carly's. I already read that. She's built like a brick house. Phyllis said, Terry said, I'm thick. That's why black men love me. Phyllis said, isn't that cushion for motion? No, it's more cushion for the pushing. You got to get it right, Phyllis. Terry says, Carly's got the booty. She does have a booty. Keith said, Carly's got that comeback pussy. Sonny keeps coming back to it. Now, he only wants that. I disagree with that. That's not what it is. He just wants her when he can't have her. That's all. And Phyllis said, I don't like Britt, but she's growing on me. I love Britt. Of course, you guys know she's about to go on, or she is on reoccurring now, so we won't see too much of her anymore, which sucks. So that sucks.
Mm-hmm. That sucks, because I really like her. I really enjoy her, and I feel like they could do so much with her character. But I guess rumor has it Kelly is looking to go towards other things, so maybe they plan to recast her. Maybe, because I feel like Britt has too much on the can, like too many ties to the canvas. Like, she has her brother, she has her mother, she, you know, like there's just a lot of stuff going on right now. And
I hope she's not off the. Paula said she's off the Bold and the Beautiful. I really hope not.
No, Kelly tweeted not too long ago saying that she wasn't going to the Bold and the Beautiful.
Oh, okay, good.
Yeah, she tweeted about it, and she said she's not going to the Bold and the Beautiful.
So you guys heard that directly from the horse's mouth. Kelly said she is not going to the Bold and the Beautiful, which is Britt. So.
I think what I heard is that she wants prime time. So she, you know,
yeah, prime time in movies. That's what I heard.
Yeah. So she's going to be going to that stuff. And but, yeah, I think they put her on reoccurring because they want to keep her long enough that they can probably recast. I feel like they're going to recast her. If they don't, then I'll be sad because I like Britt. And I think they should keep the character at least on the canvas because I feel like they can get so much more out of Britt.
Phyllis said, aren't you admins hooked up with the writers of GH? No, we are not. But we do know the exact sources to go to get the credible information. We don't directly interact with them, Sometimes we do on Twitter. They will answer our questions and give us, real feedback on our, questions. But for the most part, we're not really directly linked to them at all.
Yeah,
we're just a little Facebook group. We're trying to get there, but right now we're just a little Facebook group, and we use all the, and we're just very what's the word I'm looking for? We know where to get the information that's
we have a lot of really good credible sources, and if all else fails, you can just jump on Twitter and ask. All the cast members that have a Twitter. I mean, they all interact with the fans, and it's just, it's pretty easy to get, information out of them. And they use Twitter as a medium to make announcements, like, recently Tyler, addressed rumors that he would be leaving, and he said that he wasn't leaving, that he was just taking some time off, and it was just, wasn't really, like, a long vacation. It was just going to be, like, because I guess it got brought up in an interview that he had 4 months off, but he corrected everyone, so did Ron, and, they pretty much said that he wasn't, going off for 4 months. He was just, taking a week off here or a week off there and, kind of spreading around. But as for you can jump on Twitter and ask them anything, and a lot of them will answer, so.
Yeah. It's really, we have access to them as much as anyone else does. So, we're working on having a little bit more ties to them. Now, you've seen our picture. You're probably mistaking our picture with the cast holding our sign saying they're fans of General Hospital. They love the fans of General Hospital and Censored. At General Hospital and Censored, I'm sorry. But we don't know them directly, but we try our damnedest to get our hands on them and have them do things for us. So in that incident we had, I forgot her name. Do you remember what her name was?
Her name was Debbie or Deborah or something like that.
Deborah. Her name is Deborah. That's what it was. Debbie or Deborah. Yeah. She went to a General Hospital event, and she printed our sign up that we gave her, and she took it to the event. And she asked them, could you please take a picture of the sign? And they were so sweet to do it for us. And it was, like, the most awesome day of my life. Like, I was so on cloud nine. I couldn't stop smiling all day when I seen that picture. So
oh, yeah.
She sent that to us, and that was awesome. So if anybody, speaking of that, if any of you guys do go to any General Hospital events, please let us know. We will definitely get a sign to you. And we would love to get some other cast members with our sign. It's so awesome. Okay. All right, so let's get back to the show. Let's see. So we talked about Elizabeth's house. Let's talk about Jordan. Okay, so Jordan wasn't on too much this week, but enough where we should, address what's going on with her. Jordan had a mystery man come up to her, and it was like on a Friday, I think, and we thought that it was probably TJ's dad. Come to find out, it wasn't TJ's dad. It was another DA, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was a DA. And he was basically touching base with her. So he wasn't nothing for us to worry about. I really thought he was going to be TJ's dad. And I think they purposely are teasing us with that. So I really think that TJ's dad is coming back. This is just my opinion. This is not fact or documented anywhere. But I think just by knowing the way General Hospital works and how they like to tease us and kind of fuck with our brains, I think they wanted us to think that was TJ's dad. That's why they did it that way. And he was black, and he was like, hello, Jordan, and he was good looking. And I think they wanted us to think that was TJ's dad. So
yeah.
I think they're trying to put that little thought in our ear, in our brains, so that we'll start to think, what if TJ's dad comes back? And I think that's what they're going to end up doing. Because it would be only right. It would be nice and messy. He just came and talked to her. And then Sean and Jordan told TJ the truth about everything. And TJ obviously didn't take it too well. For a moment there, he thought that she was going to tell him that Sean was his dad. But, she didn't. Now, this has happened, I think, the week the other week, but I'm just bringing it up again because it all ties in together. When Jordan, I think, said that, you know, that's your dad. And I think Sean said to him, I'm trying to remember how it went. Didn't Sean say to him, no, your mom got the test and she said that you're not, that I'm not your father or something like that. Something
yeah.
like that happened.
Yeah,
but the way Jordan's face
done.
Looked.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Oh, yeah. He said that she had a test done, but I guess it came back, well, according to Jordan.
Mm-hmm.
Came back.
Exactly.
That.
It was according to her. He didn't see the test himself. So when he brought that up to TJ, the way that Jordan was kind of looking away from the camera, it kind of looked like she knew something that they didn't know. So I'm thinking that that is still his dad. Sean's his dad. And, you know, they broke all this news to him, telling him what happened with their dad and how his dad tried to shoot Sean and all that good stuff. And he's, you know, really upset. So... TJ goes running to Molly, crying about what happened. And who opens the door? Like, brand new Molly. We've seen her all grown up on her Twitter and her face, her Instagram and all that. We've seen her all pretty and made up with her makeup. But today, not today, but that day on the show was the first time she's looked all grown up on General Hospital that I know of. Am I right?
Yeah, it's the first time, like, we've seen her with her new bangs and her, yeah, she looked like a woman.
Yeah, she had her makeup on, her eyeliner. She looked very grown, almost too grown to me. I felt like it was a little much. I think they should have warmed us up to the idea. You know, like,
mm-hmm.
maybe start with some eyeliner, a little bit of eyeliner, and then maybe a little bit of lipstick. But, yeah, she was all made up, real pretty, but... yeah, so he goes crying to Molly all about what happened, and they have a little heart-to-heart. And before he came, we see Molly was going through her things with her dad's stuff, so obviously she's missing him. So hopefully, I keep forgetting that this man isn't dead, so at some point they got to bring this guy back, which should be happening soon once all this fluke stuff comes out, because this will kind of, you know, open a door for more things to come out. So... hopefully that's going to start coming out soon. And then also, yeah, that's it with Jordan. Now, you want to go ahead and talk about Fluke, that whole situation, because I don't pay attention
yeah,
to this.
Yeah, sure. Well, okay. Right now, Tracy, Lulu, Sam, and Patrick are trying to get the jump on... the Lord Ashton, you know.
I hate him.
Gosh, oh yeah. He's kind of a pain in the ass. He's like a Luke knockoff. He kind of reminds me of a Luke knockoff. Like, they're trying, you know, like, he tries too hard to be just like Luke, and he's not Luke. So, but anyways, so yeah, they're trying to get the jump on him and trying to figure out what's going on. They got into the locked deposit box, and they got a flash drive, which they, you know, put in the computer. And turns out they found a WSB file that has plans to create a mask. And so what they do, they're trying to figure out who the mask's for, what the mask's for, whatever. And then, you know, they're suspecting that, you know, maybe it could be you know, a mask of Luke, it could be a mask of, you know, anybody. And it doesn't, like, the picture that they look, or they're looking at, or the schematics they're looking at, isn't really clear on who it is.
Mm-hmm.
And so...
that's where I've been confused, because they're making it seem like there's two Flukes and one Luke.
Yeah.
So I told Cher earlier, like, you're going to have to cover this storyline because I'm totally confused. I'm not interested in it. So, yeah, you figure it out.
So, you know, we saw, you know, Luke on Friday in Miss Savage, and he got free of his restraints, and he managed to get out of his cell. And, you know, obviously he's met with Fluke, who is holding a gun on him. And they have a conversation, and they have a conversation, and it's pretty much, you know, Luke is trying to figure out who is impersonating him. And, you know, he accuses Luke of wearing a mask, and of course, and Luke says that he's not wearing a mask, and he pinches his skin to kind of show off that it's not, he's not wearing a mask. And so he talks about how things have kind of gotten complicated for Luke Spencer in Fort Charles, and how he has to make provisions to preserve his position, you know, in Port Charles. And so I'm actually kind of bringing up this recap. I'm going to read this one little part, Kimberly. It's just that little one paragraph. No, yeah. Okay, Miscavige, Fluke pulls a gun on Luke as he tries to escape. Fluke begins recapping his schemes to Luke, including making everyone believe Jerry Jacks kidnapped him and sending them Larry Ashton instead of returning Luke to his family. Fluke wonders why Larry has been brought into this and suspects Fluke is Larry with plastic surgery or a mask like Faison used to wear. So that's what makes me think that it's Larry is Fluke wearing a mask. Like, Larry is not, more or less, it's Fluke. Fluke has had his plastic surgery. He looks like Luke. But since he cannot walk, I guess getting in as Larry Ashton was kind of a way to get him in so that he could get information without, you know, getting a bunch of million questions of, you know, like, where have you been, Luke? Why haven't you been answering your phone? Your daughter got kidnapped. Why weren't you there? Your son, your grandson got kidnapped. Why weren't you there? Blah, blah, blah. And yada, yada, yada. And all, I mean, you know, I think he wanted to get in there without, you know, being past, you know, getting stuck in a bunch of, with a bunch of questions.
Mm-hmm.
And have to explain himself. So I think he had a mask made of Larry Ashton. And he's wearing that now. That's what I think. That's what made me think of that. And then Luke is still Luke. Luke says he is not Larry Ashton and pulls on his face claiming that he's not wearing a mask. At that point, he wasn't wearing a mask. So Luke will tell him no more and says that he leaves, that he will let the orderlies give him, or have the orderlies give him a tighter straitjacket. He ties him back up. And Luke vows that he will kill his imposter. And after that, Julian gives a confession, pretty much tells, you know, Alexis that Luke has an imposter who has stolen his life, more or less. And at first, Alexis doesn't believe him. And, you know, she obviously, you know, has a lot of reasons to not believe him. You know, they've had, you know, several, you know, issues with him lying, and she's not sure if she wants to believe him or not. And so, you know, he says, get me out of jail, and I'll take you to Luke. So he does just that. She gets him out of jail. He takes her to Luke. This is where she finds Luke in his cell. And so she unties him out of his straitjacket and takes him back to the Quartermains. And obviously, we end up at the Quartermains, and, you know, there he is. I think it's Luke. I don't know what everybody else thinks, but I think it's Luke, the real Luke, and then Larry, and Larry Ashton is actually not Larry Ashton, but Luke wearing a mask. That's my theory.
Larry said, that's Luke. Phyllis said, when Luke winked at Tracy, she knew that was the real McCoy. I agree. You know, there's certain things that are different, certain little characteristics that the real Luke only has. However, you know, you never know. I mean, they could be pulling our strings. I mean, it's not so hard to figure Luke out either, or to imitate him, you know. I mean
it's just that Luke was so obviously not Luke because he didn't use his nicknames. He didn't call Tracy Spanky Buns. He didn't call Lulu Gumdrop or Princess.
He didn't get that far though either.
Yeah.
Though. Didn't it end, his part end after?
No. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about when Fluke was in town and playing being Luke.
No, I'm saying when he walked into the quarter maze and he winked at them and all that stuff.
Yeah, I was getting to that. I was getting to that. When he called Alexis Natasha, because Fluke would have just called Alexis.
Right.
Luke would have called him Natasha.
I don't know. I mean, I'm thinking outside the box now. So, you know, like I said, I haven't really followed it. Julie said, you know, I really don't pay attention that much. I kept catch bits and pieces, and I tried to watch it today again to just be able to have something to talk about it, but it really was, like, hurting me to watch because I'm just not interested at all. But I was just thinking outside the box, like, what if they didn't show what happened after the Fluke came in and talked to him and everything in the hospital. They didn't show what happened from there, so you never know.
Yeah.
What if the real Fluke, tied him up again? I mean, Fluke tied him up again and had him tied up on the bed, and he went back off and acted like he was Luke, as he has been doing, and went to the quarter main. You know, he could have just tied him back up again and left him there. Because it would have had to have been Luke taking out Fluke in order to get out of there.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll see, of course.
And how did Alexis and Julian so effortlessly get by security?
Yeah.
You know?
True.
It was just too easy. So I'm really thinking that's not Fluke.
But then again,
that's
I don't know. Fluke didn't know that. I mean, I don't think, obviously, Julian was in jail, so he had no access to get a hold of Fluke or talk to Fluke.
Uh-huh.
So I don't think Fluke knew about Julian telling Alexis. And so obviously not enough time to, you know, put provisions down and be like, don't let, you know, so-and-so. So obviously everyone thinks that Julian is, you know, persona grata and thinks that, you know, he's allowed because, you know, nobody's ever said any different, and Luke doesn't know that he's betrayed him, so, or Fluke doesn't know that that Julian's betrayed him. So, I don't know. I still think that it's quite there, because, I don't know, there's something about, you know, that Larry Ashton was, you know, like how he mentioned Kiki. He's never met Kiki.
Right.
He's never met Kiki. He's never spent time with Kiki. He doesn't know. I mean, I'm surprised he didn't even, like, why are you mentioning Kiki when you don't know anything about Kiki? And obviously, when you come back, you come back on the heels of Michael breaking up with Kiki. So you're asking how Kiki is? Why are you asking how Kiki is? You have no vested interest, and you know that they're broken up or they're having issues. So, you know, it just didn't seem like something, you know, he should be asking him because, you know, Larry Ashton is virtually a stranger when it comes to Michael because he doesn't know Michael.
Mm-hmm.
So how would he know, you know, why would he ask about Kiki? But now Fluke, on the other hand, would ask about Kiki because he's attracted to Kiki. He tried to rape Kiki.
True. Yeah, that's
true. And so as for, I also saw that, you know, he kind of leered at Olivia. So,
all right, let's read somebody's comments really quick. Hold on.
Yeah.
Phyllis said, Luke and... Okay, wait. Phyllis said, Luke and Helena are the only ones that call Alexis Natasha. That's it. But, you know, that's easy for someone else to know, too. I mean, I know that. You know that. So why wouldn't anybody else know that he calls her... Alexis. I mean,
if Fluke and Helena are working together, she could have told him that.
Yeah, so. I mean, it's been years. He's been calling her Natasha. Anybody can know that. Julian called Fluke. Julie said, I've heard Robin brings back the real Luke to Port Charles. Terry said, Alexis was on the phone to Sam when Julian showed up. Plenty of time to call Fluke. Phyllis said, what's up Helena's sleeve for this whole storyline?
I have something to say about what Jerry said. As for Alexis was on the phone with Sam, when was Alexis on the phone with Sam? When he got arrested? Is that what you're talking about? Was he not arrested? Because he couldn't have made a phone call to Flick if he was in jail, because he was in a cell. He was in supervised and in a cell. So I don't know when he would make it. Are you talking about when he got arrested? No? Are you talking about while he was in jail? He made a phone call while he was in jail. Before he got out? No, I don't think so. No, I don't think so. I think he was released into Alexis's custody. He was supervised at all times. They just don't hand off, you know, just like, they're like, free go, and then Alexis is waiting in the car. No, they have to hand him off to Alexis. She would have been released into her custody. So he wouldn't have had a time moment to call. I don't think he would.
Let's see if we can bring Steve in and see if he has any feedback on that. He's not in the chat, so I'm going to try to ask him if he wants to talk, but he's not in the chat thing. Hey, Steve. Steven. Sugary nipples. He hung up. He must not be right. I guess that means he doesn't have anything to say. Well, anyways, all right. So, well, I guess we'll find out. You know, I'm not really too interested in that storyline. So, yeah, it said he hung up. So, I don't know what that's about. So, yeah, if anybody else wants to call in, Ashley, Keith, Kelly, Paula, Phyllis, guest 12 and 11, Karen, Terry, please call in and we can get you guys' opinions on the show. I mean, on the General Hospital show. We do want to hear you guys' feedback. It's just not all about me and Cheryl. We all want to hear your thoughts, too. So please call in the number below on the bottom of your screen. So let's see. So I guess, you know, we'll find out about the Fluke thing. I think next week will give us a lot more. You know, we missed 2 days this week that they could have gave us more info. So I think next week is going to definitely probably give us some insight on what's going on. Kelly said, I'm not into the Fluke story. Lost interest quite some time ago. Same here, Kelly. I thought when the story came back, I was going to be excited about it. You know, like, oh, okay, we're going to find out who Fluke is. But I really don't care. I mean, I just want it to be over with because I feel like it's wasting a lot of time right now. We could be talking about Jason, or we could be talking about Rosalie's secret. We could focus more on Michael's storyline, you know, Kiki and Morgan can end up back in bed together. You know, there's a lot of other things that could be going on besides another mask storyline. So, which if it was maybe if it was something more interesting, if it had a different kind of twist, I'd be more interested in it. But since it's another mask storyline, basic, you know, pretty much, you know, I'm just not feeling it. So let's see. Okay, so Ashley said, I heard this week was very boring. Do we know what Rosalie's secret is now? No, we still don't know what Rosalie's secret is. Hopefully that's coming soon, too.
They haven't showed her all week. So
yeah, she hasn't been on.
Yeah.
We know that she got banged out by Michael, and that was the last we've seen her.
Yeah.
Never mind. All right, I'm not going to get back on that subject. Okay, Kelly said, I don't care anymore. Tony looks like he's been through a rough time, and playing two people takes its toll. They need to end it.
Tony actually wanted this. He asked for this.
Who?
Tony asked for
this. Oh, you're talking about Luke, the character.
Yeah.
Luke. Yeah, Tony,
he asked for it. He wanted to. The reason why he looks rough is because he had two back surgeries, and he's been recovering for 6 months.
Paula said, week of December 8th for Rosalie's Secret. I can't wait. I'm dying to know what her background is before his surgery. Okay. Terry, you're on the call? Okay. All right, Terry, you're live.
Hello?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Terry.
Hi. Can we go back? Can I talk about the Fluke thing?
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't know if you guys had went past that or not.
Nope.
The reason why I think that is Fluke, and why, I mean, that was just too easy. for them to get him out of
You're talking about you're talking about who showed up at the Quartermains. You think that's
right.
Still fluke.
I think that's still fluke. And
me too.
And this is what I think about Julian, why I think he called fluke. When they said that they had Anna told what's her name? Alexis. That they had held him the 48 hours and they couldn't hold him any longer.
Uh-huh.
And
but they're still with
him. And so they released him and he had plenty of time to pick up his phone and call Fluke.
Mm-hmm.
But why would he?
Why would he?
I mean, seriously, he hates the guy. And the only reason he's still in the business is because his family's being threatened. Why would he call, you know, to let him know that he's about to betray him? Like,
because he knows that Fluke would kill his whole family and everything, and he's concerned about
it. To be honest with you, when you're at a police station, you're never alone. When you're getting released, you still have to process paperwork. They would have taken him, escorted him over to Alexis. Alexis would have taken custody of him, and then they would have left the station.
Yeah, they would have. I agree with you, but we're talking about a soap opera.
But I
still
feel like you said. I mean, I'm with you, Terry. I think it was just too easy, and for a storyline that's been drawn out so long and so, you know, confusing and leaving us on the edge of our seat trying to figure out what the hell is going on, for him to just walk out of that place so easy, it doesn't make sense.
And
it would have been basically a waste of all of our time for them to do it that easy. So I really don't think that's Fluke. I mean, I don't think that's Luke. And I think when Alexis came in and he's like, oh, Natasha, oh, I've been waiting. Oh, he was all, you know, overdoing it. I thought it was just it was drawn out. It was dramatic. And I felt like it was bullshit. I think that was not.
And one other thing, too. Fluke did call Alexis Natasha that time that he went over to her house before her house blew up. He went in to kill Alexis because Julian was going to quit the business, and he called her Natasha at the door.
Mm-hmm. Well, so. Yeah. I don't know, but look.
I just think it's crazy how that's the only nickname that Fluke has used. I can't remember. I'm going to have to rewatch that. But, if that's true, then that's interesting because that's the only
He does say Port Chuck, but
He hasn't said Port Chuck, or well, he has when he's talking to, you know, the real Luke. But
right.
As far as, you know, he hasn't called Lulu Princess, he hasn't called her Gumdrop, he hasn't called Tracy's Banking, he just calls everybody by their names. But yeah, Alexis is the only one that he calls by the nickname. You know, if he studied Luke so closely for all these years, why wouldn't he know these nicknames?
Yeah, that's
and why
true.
Wouldn't he use these nicknames? I don't know. I just think I thought it was.
Well,
was
he
weird.
Really hasn't had a chance to get into that all that either. He just basically just showed up there, so there wasn't
I'm
chance. No,
I'm not talking about now. I'm talking about previously.
Oh, previously. Well,
yeah.
The reason why I'm saying that is because we're thinking that Luke has been released. You know, so that's why I'm bringing it up, because the defining moment is going to be when we start to see the conversations flowing on Monday, when the conversations start flowing at the Quartermain's place. You know,
mm-hmm.
That's when things, everything else before that we know has been pretty much fluke, and, you know, we know that's all been bullshit. But I'm talking about, like, these conversations coming up now, those are going to be really be able to tell. And I just don't think
but
that.
But didn't he used to call, I'm sorry, I didn't mean for up sure you talked to him, but didn't Fluke, when he was alone with Tracy, call her Spanky a few times?
No, I don't think I've ever seen it. I think I've always ever heard him call her Tracy.
I could have swore that he
called her Spanky when he was Fluke, too, when he was messing. I don't know. I just don't think that's Luke who – I think that they want them to – I think that people – they know that people are on to them, and they know that people are getting suspicious about this Fluke guy, and that they have to do something. And what they're doing is they're making it look like that he's been rescued, because that'll make everybody back at ease and thinking that he's home, and they'll stop digging. You know, because they'll think that they've rescued him and he's home. So that's going to shut people up for a little while they finish whatever their mission is. That's what I think.
You know,
Can I say something else about, you know, with Duke and all, with all that crap? I think Duke is not really Duke. I think the mask was made for Duke because he is not acting like Duke. And he's trying to, I mean, Luke is trying to take over Sonny's business. So Duke is going to be taking it over. So he is working for Luke.
We're gonna get to that, Terry. We're gonna get to that topic next. I mean, not next, but we're gonna touch on the whole takeover situation. Is that next? Actually, yeah. Let me see.
I just, you know, while I was on the phone, I just wanted to put that in there.
We have an order, Terry. You need to follow the order, okay?
Well, I'm sorry. Darn it.
You have to call back and use your minutes when we get on that topic, okay? No, but yeah, we're going to talk about, I mean, we might as well, since we're there. We were going to talk about Michael and Carly next, but we'll just go ahead and talk about the Sonny and him, the conversation with Sonny and Duke about possibly taking over the business, which you made a good point. You just made a really good point, Terry, because I didn't think about it like that. He really hasn't been acting like the original Duke lately. And almost, I think I kind of like didn't even pay attention to it because I figure, yeah, he's mad at Anna for arresting him. But he has snapped at her a couple times, and it's kind of out of his character.
I mean,
I have never seen him turn on Anna that way.
Yeah.
It's just so out of character for Duke, even though I don't like Duke, that is out of character for him.
Yeah, it is. Usually he would still understand where she's coming from. That's usually his whole approach to that, you know, to her accusations and the shit she says about him being in the business and all that stuff. Usually his approach is, you know, he understands where she's coming from. He might not agree with it, but, you know, he understands. But he just kind of like, you know, snapped on her a couple times. So I wonder if he is wearing a mask. And this is part of their plan, is to get Sonny locked up, get Sonny to trust this Duke enough to take over the business and give him all his valuable information to be able to run his business.
I wonder if they have several masks that are in play. Like, I don't know. Because they're on business, you know, I don't know.
Because they're saying that Luke is not, not Luke. Luke is not a mask. Yeah. But they didn't say about anybody else not being a mask.
Yeah, I don't know. Ron said that he didn't want to do the mask thing anymore, but I don't know. Maybe he has decided against it. I mean, he's had
Cheryl,
to
muffled.
Think about it. Sorry, he's had 6 months to think about it, so maybe he changed his mind.
I mean, they made a Duke mask before, so I don't know.
Yeah. We'll have to see.
Let's see what people are saying in the group. Okay. In the chat. Okay, so Julian wants to get back, and Alexis, good grace, da-da-da-da. Let's see. Julie says, I believe that, Terry. It looked like Luke in that computer thing. Phyllis said, way before this Fluke bullshit, Luke in Hot Moments called Tracy Spanky. Well, yeah, he did. He called her Spanky, not even Hot Moments. Just that was his nickname for her, period. Phyllis said, Duke with the mob ways, and Anna's chat on the PC was really Duke. I don't know about that. Julie says, sorry, I mean, Duke looked like the computer image Pat and Sam found. I agree, Julie. That's what I thought. I thought when it was pulling up that it was more resembling Duke than it was Luke, too. So maybe, you know, it didn't generate completely, so they kind of, I don't know, but I felt like it looked like Duke, too. And I'm guessing that Terry is right with this, and it never crossed my mind until you said that either, Terry. So that's a good observation.
I just, you know, I've been thinking that for a few days, you know, ever since. I was like, well, he is not acting right. That is not like Duke. I mean, to be so, you know, just, he's supposed to love Anna, you know, and for him just to do all this stuff to her, that just he's always been nice to her. And plus, what is this thing going on with him and Lucy? You know, is Lucy involved in it?
Nah. Mm-hmm. Nah, I think Lucy just has a little crush.
Yeah, if anything is going on, if anything is going on between the two of them, I think she's oblivious to that part of it.
She's,
I mean, it's Lucy.
I don't think she'd be involved in that. I don't think that's not her. That's not her. That's not how
I don't know. When she first came to town, she was with that one guy. I can't remember his name. And it was all for, I think she was covering up a murder or something for him or something. I can't remember.
Yeah. I think that's far-fetched. I'm not with you on that one, Terry.
I just don't like Lucy, so.
You're just trying to get her involved in shit. You're trying to get
her
locked
up. Okay, well, darn it.
You failed.
I failed, damn. I thought I was better than that. I almost said gooder.
Nice try. Maybe next time. We'll find something to pin on her later.
Okay. All right. Well, I'm going to hang up because of my minutes. But I'll see you on the show thing.
All right. Call back, okay?
All right. All bye-bye.
Okay. So let's see. Steve, can you hear me?
Yeah. Hold on a second.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, hold on. I just got to take you out. Speaker.
Better that way.
Okay.
How you doing? Happy late Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving to you, too.
All right. So do you want to chime in? Do you care about this whole Fluke storyline at all?
Yes, I do. And I've always maintained I don't care how long it takes to get to a certain point. I know they had to go. They had to delay it because he had to have the 6 months for his back surgery and all that. And I'm fine with that. I was perfectly entertained by all the other stories in between. Now they're kind of getting back into it, you know. For me, it's like the journey isn't the getting there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there's always another good story to follow along, you know. I don't know. It's just, I've never been the one to get bent up over, oh, my God, this is taking forever. It's driving me crazy. I've never been that type of person to...
Yeah, I don't think it's so much of the whole taking so long. It's just, like, the whole, like, mass thing again. Like, it's just, like, you know, wanting them to be a little bit more creative with the, you know, I don't know, try to take it somewhere else instead of just always it being a mask.
Yeah.
So do you think
it's like I can see them all, like, just cackling over there and, you know, rubbing their hands together, you know, how they're getting us all worked up over it because, you know, they are really trying to throw every screw in there to, you know, get you all worked up.
I agree. When you look at it like that, too, you know that they really sit down and they discuss the stuff with their little team and what will make us squirm or what will make us react. And, you know, I think they're very calculated with what they decide to throw at us and their moves. And they know exactly what kind of responses they're going to get in return. And I think they have a ball doing that to us, just kind of like pulling our strings and, you know, and teasing us. Now, do you think that who showed up at the Quartermains on Thanksgiving, do you think that's Fluke or Luke?
I want to say no.
No,
because
which one?
because I want to say no that it's not Luke. Because, like, when they showed Fluke, you know, when he went to visit Luke before he went and had his back surgery for real, he was saying how much studying had gone into, you know, like all the little things like calling Alexis Natasha and stuff like that.
Right.
He's studied. I mean, he knows his stuff. I mean, he's obviously done his homework. You know, I would be very surprised if that actually does turn out to be Luke because it would be so disappointing if that's how it plays out.
Right.
Because that we wouldn't get that emotional payoff, if you know what I mean.
Exactly. That's the perfect way of describing it. That's what I was trying to say. I was trying to say exactly what you just said, but I feel like all of they've put into this and all the work they've put into this working us up for this moment to reveal him and have this all come out at the end, for him to just walk out of that hospital so easily and go home, it just wouldn't make sense.
And
now
he's back home. And I can see how they're going to play with us for a while. I can see that probably for the next couple of weeks, they're probably going to just play it safe and, oh, okay, this is Luke. And then all of a sudden, what we least expected, bam.
Yeah, exactly. I think that they're just trying. I think, like I was saying earlier, they were getting kind of, they know that people are starting to get suspicious, so they had to do something quick. And this was the best way for them to do it. And so now everybody's going to calm their little panties, and they're going to be, you know, thinking Luke's home, and they're going to be happy, and they're not going to be suspicious anymore because they're going to think they rescued him. And that's going to buy them more time to do whatever they're still trying to do. So that's what I think, and I'm with you. I think that's exactly – I don't think that the writers would be so, you know, so not – just not – I don't think they would do that to us. I don't think they would just leave us hanging like that with, like, okay, he's just home. You know, that's what good would that have been? You know, it's not enough. We need that moment. I mean, it's been dragged out and you know, boosted up and, you know, played up for so long now. Why would it just be so easy for him to just walk out the hospital and just, bam, I'm home and everything's cool and everything's back to normal? I doubt it.
Yeah.
So,
and I guess there has to be that big emotional payoff.
Yeah, exactly. Know? Emotional payoff is the perfect word.
And it, I don't know, for me, it just didn't ring true. I did not think for a single minute that was Luke that they were walking out with.
Yeah, because the way he walked in, too, he didn't walk in like a man who's been captive all this time. He walked in like a man that had nothing happen to him. Like, he walked in all cool and suave like he always does, you know. This man has been locked up, drugged up, all kinds of stuff for, you know, whatever they want to say, months or however long they're trying to make it seem like. You know, he wouldn't have walked in so cool. It would have been more like, I'm home, oh, my God, I'm so happy, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And we don't know how much of a period of time there was in between the time that Helena pulled out that knife and held it under his chin to where Sam and Patrick walked up and saw her there.
Yeah.
You know, so, I mean, anything could have happened. She could have gotten him out of there, had some goons spirit him away off, you know, and then put Luke in there in place and, you know. Yeah, I really believe that that's what's going on. I could be wrong. You never know.
No, I think we're on the same page with that. Now, as far as what do you think about Terry's little – did you hear Terry's theory about Duke not being Duke and being another mask wearer guy?
I kind of wonder. That could be. I don't know.
Because
I did not hear her mention that.
Yeah, she said. Now she did mention how he's just kind of not been himself. Like, he's been kind of snappy towards Anna. Now we know he's probably upset that she locked him up, but she warned him, so there's no reason for him really to be upset, you know, because she gave him the chance to confess. So there's not really a reason for him to be mad at her. And usually his character, his. The way he comes at her about this kind of stuff is, you know, yeah, I fucked up. I know I'm wrong, but, you know, he's not usually snappy at her. He's been kind of snappy at her and, you know, jumping down her throat about several things. Like, he compared his situation to her situation with Faison and, you know, and stuff like that. You know, just the way he said it was just kind of mean and kind of just, like, condescending a little bit, you know. So, I don't know. I mean, it could be, and this would be the perfect time for it to be a mask, because Sonny is now ready to give up his business to this guy. You know? So if this guy is wearing a mask and he's not the real Duke, and the Duke is locked up somewhere or whatever, wherever he is or whatever's going on, Sonny is about to hand over his business to the enemy and not even know it.
I had such a big laugh when Duke had asked him, well, what about Sean? Are you kidding? He'll burn it down to the ground.
He'll have it not even 24 hours, and that business will be gone to hell. I don't know.
That's kind of something interesting to think about. I never thought about that. I guess we'll kind of find out, you know, this next week.
Yeah, I didn't think about it at all either until she had said that. So this week while I'm watching, I'm going to be looking at Duke a little bit differently, you know, just in case. I'm not completely sold on the idea yet, but it's definitely something to consider.
I am happy that they're giving Anna more screen time now, or Fenella, because I think she deserves it. She's always been one of my favorites for forever since she's been on the show. And to have her actually finally get, you know, some real concrete storyline in now, it's awesome.
Right. I agree. Because she's one of the characters, like there's a lot of old characters that have been on there for years and years and years, and they come and go, but their stories are never all that strong, and they kind of don't always blend back into what's going on effortlessly. You know what I mean? It's like they're kind of thrown, like Felicia, she's just kind of thrown in there every once in a while, but she doesn't really have anything solid going on, or she doesn't kind of like mesh with what's going on, you know, at the time she's thrown back in. But Anna, it's like whenever they put her in, she always just kind of snaps back in it. She has family still here. You know, she has grandbabies. Yeah. She has a job. So she still comes back in, and she comes and she just – it's like she never left when she comes back. Felicia, I never can, like, warm right back up to her. Like, I'm just kind of like, okay, oh, you're back. Okay. You know, it's not really like – she doesn't really have, like, a purpose. She just kind of comes back because that's what she does. But, yeah, I agree. I think
Anna,
I
wish they'd make up their minds with them. I wish they'd make up their mind who the mayor is going to be.
Who the mayor? Oh, I forgot all about that. I hope it's not her. I like Felicia, but, yeah, I don't see her as mayor type.
I don't see that either.
Let's see if anybody's commenting. I didn't have my screen up. Let's see. Phyllis said, last night I spent 2 hours on Wikipedia doing research on this storyline. What storyline, Phyllis? Okay, wait. What is she talking about? Hold on. Okay, Faison on the door, Larry. Okay, I can't follow that right now. Paula said the moment will come just when Luke is about to kill Fluke. Well, I don't know. We'll see. So I don't know. I think there's several masks going on. And the fact that they said when Fluke was in the hospital with Luke confronting him, and he said that, you know, he said that he was, well, we knew obviously he was wearing a mask or something or had surgery because he was in his face with the original Luke. But he also kind of insinuated that there's another Fluke somewhere wearing a mask as well. So if there's another Fluke somewhere wearing a mask as well, why wouldn't there be also another Duke wearing a mask too? You know, they love making Duke masks. And then Faison is back in the equation, and he's been out for who knows how long out of that hole. So who knows with all that maskism.
Last week when they were showing them, when they got the flash drive and they were running it on the laptop at the tournament, then it would look like it was the schematics for a mask. Did they ever show who that supposedly was supposed to be, or did they just leave you hanging?
No, they didn't show us, but I believe it was Julie who had mentioned that it did look more like Duke. Underneath all the little lines and stuff, it looked like it was almost more resembling Duke than it was Luke, whatever that mask was that came up. But they never showed the finishing, the finished product. So who knows? Oh, wait, Cheryl's back on. Yeah, so
I think it's interesting how all of these names rhyme: Duke, Fluke, and Luke.
Yeah, it's annoying. You know I'm bad with names anyway, so throwing all
it's
those
the year.
familiar names around, they're too similar.
It's the year of the oak.
What about the WSB special agent, the mask guy? Who is that, Phyllis? What did she
there
talk
was
about?
Something.
Maybe she's talking about from the Justice Department, that guy is trying to nail Anna.
Oh, yeah, him. I forgot about him.
Yeah.
The guy who's determined to get her locked up.
It seems really, like, it's crazy because, you know, like, I mean, it's been implied that, you know, they have a relationship and from, you know, not like a romantic relationship, but, you know, a mentor-mentee relationship. Like, she pretty much taught him everything he knows. So you'd think that they would like each other, you know, and they would want to help each other, you know, like, you know, they would have a good, you know, civil relationship as far as, you know, coworkers and colleagues and things like that. So it's really crazy how he is so determined. It's really crazy to me how so determined he is to bring down Anna. Like, you know, it's like it's borderline he has a vendetta against her for some reason.
Yeah.
So.
I found it kind of weird how how Anna confesses to putting Luke, I mean, what the fuck? What's his name? Faison in a hole, you know. She's confessing to it. Oh, he's been down there a year. Me and Robert, we knew that all this time. And she still not locked up. You know, why wouldn't she automatically be arrested for that? You know, is that not okay? I mean, is that allowed? Are you allowed to just go randomly lock people up for, you know? Like, they act like it's like it wasn't a crime. He might not have killed him, but she still committed a crime.
Yeah. Yeah, but it's like, I don't know. I just noticed that it just feels like it's to the point that he is, like, determined to get her on anything.
Yeah.
And he's determined to, like, prosecute her, and, you know, and I'm trying to figure out why, because, you know, I was like, wouldn't this be considered, like, a conflict of interest, considering, you know, they were friends and colleagues once upon a time? I did soap, so, you know, that doesn't really fly, but I don't know. But it just seems really weird to me that he's so determined to bring her down and to get her arrested and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It doesn't add up to me. I have a feeling that Faison is involved in this, or somebody's involved who has something against Anna is involved in this and has sent this guy.
Yeah.
So.
Well, that's another storyline I'm not too interested in.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I think there's more that's going to come out about those two, too. Maybe they were lovers.
Right.
And he has some kind of vendetta against her.
Yeah, maybe he feels, like, jilted or something, you know.
Yeah. Maybe she dumped him and he's all in his feelings and sad and upset about it and all that good crap. All right. So let's see what else. Okay. Michael and Carly. Okay, Michael's whole everything, and then including Carly. Now, Michael officially signed. He changed his name. Carly came to see her son, and that didn't go too well. Yeah, he just totally just dogged her out. He did not care.
I mean, Carly should just keep her distance for a little while because, you know, she's not going to get anywhere trying to bull her way back into Michael's life. It's just not going to work.
He is not bending.
Some serious finesse. She's going to have to be patient with him. She's going to have to be gentle with him. She's going to have to be, you know, like, she can't force it. She can't sit here and be like, I'm your mother and you have to forgive me. That's
yeah, she's
fly.
Doing that at the wrong time. He's still heated.
Yeah.
You can't. You know, you can't try to, you know, come at him like that when he's still at 10. You know, you need to let him bring it down a little bit. But, yeah, the way he threw the papers at her and at her chest that had his new name on it and everything, you know, he does not give a fuck about that woman at all right now. And it's almost sad. I really feel bad for Carly at this point. You know, I'm all for the new, tougher Michael. You know, I'm okay with that. But he is being really mean, you know. I know. Steve, I know you had a problem with him being mean as well. Cheryl, I'm about to mute you for a second because it's loud. I know you have a problem with him being mean, but I was cool with it at first. But, yeah, the way he's treating his mom, it's okay not to fuck with your mom anymore or not want to have any dealings with her or disown her. But how mean he's being to her is he's really being just real disrespectful. And I understand his pain, and I know he feels like, you know, they basically, you know, they shit on him, so why should he be any kind of, you know, considerate to their feelings? But, yeah, he's just really being really dirty. What do you think, Steve?
I agree.
Yeah.
I've always felt that Michael needed to grow up here.
Yeah.
But I don't like the way he's being now. It's just the overkill. It's so extreme, which I guess, given the circumstances, you know, I mean, well, what the hell do you expect him to do, you know? But
right.
Still, I mean, just the way he was talking to Carly, I mean, it just, oh my God.
He was. Really, I felt really bad for her, and I usually don't get emotionally involved with, you know, the more the drama, the better for me, but I really felt her pain because she was acting really good herself. You know, I felt like she was a hurt mother. And I felt like she really portrayed that in her character, and I really felt her pain.
I still don't think that it has dawned on her the complete ramifications of what she and Sonny have done.
No,
like she still doesn't quite get it, and I don't know what it's going to take for her to get it.
She's used to people forgiving what she forgiving and forgetting what she does, you know, and people get over it. And I think that that's what she thinks is going to happen with Michael. She thinks if she, you know, forces herself on him a little bit, you know, he's going to understand. If she just explains herself one more time, he's going to get over it. But little by little, he's setting everything in motion and everything's getting kind of set in stone. And he doesn't look like there's any, doesn't look like there's any indication of him turning back anytime soon.
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel really bad for her. Ashley said, I don't like mean Michael. Terry said, he's kind of young. Oh, wait, that's the wrong thing. Paula said, Phyllis said, Michael has the right to feel the way he does, but she should show him some sort of respect. That's his mom. He should show her some sort of respect. That's his mom. Exactly. That's how I feel at the end of the day. You don't have to like her. You don't have to deal with her. You don't have to even claim her. But you should still show her some kind of respect. You don't have to be mean. Like I said, the way he threw those papers at her, all I kept thinking was, like, that's his mom. You know, he just kind of, like, slammed them into her chest, like,
yeah.
Here, bitch, go. You know, I was like, dang, you know, I really kind of felt bad for her. And then, you know, after he did that, she tried to come at him one more time, and he screamed at her, and she kind of, like, jumped back, like, oh, my God, like, did he just really scream at me like that? And she finally just turned away and left. And at that moment when she just left, she looked so defeated by her son and hurt. I just felt really bad for her. And I don't think it's going to get any better anytime soon at all. Phyllis said, Michael tossed them papers in her face. Carly's face was rotten to the core. Yeah, he's something else. And I'm sure they're writing him this way, so it's not the character's fault. You know, they're writing him to be this way, so he's giving us what they asked for. But I think that the writer should have made him like a good, happy medium with this. You know, grow a pair, like Steve said. But, you know, tone it down a little bit to where you're not just being nasty and, you know, and just unlikable. Because that's where he's leaning. That's where he's going with this. You know, he's coming to
that's how I thought he felt he was being with Kiki.
Kiki, yeah. Yeah, and you remember know? I was like, oh, yeah, no biggie, you know, because I thought that was just, you know, his girlfriend, he was mad. But now I see where you're coming from. I'm on board with you,
yeah.
Steve. I feel the same way you do. I feel like, and for me to say that, then it must be bad, because I kind of like all the shit starting and the, you know, the trouble. I like that stuff. That's what keeps me interested.
Yeah.
But,
yeah,
he's really been mean, and I don't want him to become an unlikable character, and that's where he's definitely going. So, let's see. All right, let's see if Cheryl's. All right, Steve, thank you. I'll call on you again.
Okay.
All right, let's see. Cheryl, see if her wind has stopped.
Hi. Okay, I wanted to say something because I wish I could talk. but anyways, the thing about it is that, you know, I think that, the whole reason, I don't know. I think Michael's in a free fall right now. And I think everybody just needs to step away and give him his space. Like, let him breathe for a minute before they start trying to fix things. Everyone's in turmoil mode, and they're like, oh, I need to fix this. I need to do damage control. But you're just making it worse. Just stay out of his way. Let him calm down and then talk to him. Because obviously he's not very reasonable right now.
Right.
And, you know, and I can't believe Carly went over there. I mean, I know she had to try, but at the same time, it was just kind of like, I felt like it was just too soon.
Yeah.
I felt like, you know, she should have waited a little bit longer and let him calm down and let him, you know. But I think she got what she, I mean, she came over and she thought that maybe she could, you know, just smooth things over and Michael would forgive her, and she really mistaken. She got, you know, but then again, she, like Steve said, I don't think she really understands exactly what she's done and how much she's hurt her son.
Yeah.
And I'm totally
agree, but I still think
he's
overboard. He's overkilling it right now.
Yeah, I mean, in the same way, yes, it's his mother. He should be more respectful, but at the same time, I think she should be kind of respectful of his.
Right. I definitely think she should back off. Yeah. At least give him a little bit of breathing space. Let him maybe, you know, he hasn't had a chance to calm down because somebody's always in his face. So, you know, give him a moment. Let him go over things in his own brain and, you know, and see how he feels and, you know, and then, you know, see if he's willing to, you know, talk to you at all.
Yeah, well, if the rumors are right and Jason is to remember who he is, hopefully Jason can mediate between the two and, you know, get Michael down, calm Michael down. Because he really needs Jason right now, I think. So.
Yeah, I agree.
So he needs that voice of reason.
Okay. Ashley said, Carol said, yes, it looked like to me he was not sure he wanted to sign the papers. And then when she came into the room, he all of a sudden signed them to show his mom. Yeah, I think he did kind of hesitate. I'm going to mute you for a second. He did kind of hesitate to sign the papers for a minute. And I think also, yeah, when Carly came in, he felt like, oh, yeah, like it kind of stirred up those emotions again. And he was like, yeah, I'm signing this, you know, I need to sign this, you know, I hate them. You know, it kind of reminded him that he wanted to do that. When he saw her again, it kind of stirred up those feelings again, and he was ready to sign them. But I think for a minute he was hesitant, and rightfully so. You know, he has been a Corinthos all his life, and it is a huge move to go change your name. So I think anybody would kind of think twice about it and have a moment of reconsideration, you know, about it. And then let's see, Phyllis said when Carly goes and sees Sunny and she tells Sunny that Michael changed his last name into Quartermain, that was hard to see. Sunny's feelings were shattered. Yeah, he was shattered, but he knew they were shattered, but at the same time, he kind of looked like he understood, you know, he fucked up. He officially did this time, and there's no getting out of what he did for once. And I think he's realizing that, you know, this is the one time he cannot get out of his mess. Kelly said, they do just need to get out his face. Kelly said, they do need to get out of his face. He has to work this out on his own. She pushed too hard. I agree, Kelly. And Ashley said, this storyline is almost why I'm just wanting to delete my 14 episodes on my DVR. let's see. Phyllis said, but Sunny and Carly should have told Michael right after AJ got shot, after Michael has time to really think about the whole thing. And Carol Jean said, yes, he will. I sure wish he would get his memory back sooner rather than later. I read in the spoilers that Jason would get his memory back on December 22nd. She's talking about Jason being the mediator between the family, son of Michael and his parents and all that stuff. And I agree. I think that I think they're going to have him get his memory back right around Christmas so that for the holidays we'll have that emotional episode. You know, you have to have a touching episode around Christmas time. You can't have all the bad stuff only happening. You got to have some good Christmas moments. So I think that's what they're saving that for. It'll be probably ideal.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think that kind of, you know, like the reunion, they'll have that big reunion between, you know, Sam and Danny and, you know, and obviously, you know, I think Elizabeth is probably going to be a little bit shattered because obviously, you know, I don't know, we'll see.
I think so, because she's going to clearly have feelings for Jake by then.
Yeah.
So to find out he is Jason is going to be shocking enough, but then to have to act like she doesn't have these feelings for this man now because he's going to want to make things right with his wife, which is what, you know, the right thing that Jason would do is he would try to make it right with his wife. But like I said before, I told you guys on previous shows, I think that he's going to try to make it right with Sam, but, you know, it's not going to be there, you know. You can't fake it. You know, he's going to try out of loyalty, but I don't think they're going to have that same connection anymore, and I think that they're not going to end up working.
Agreed. I don't know. We'll see. I mean, you know, I've kind of discussed this with other group members before, and, you know, I think someone said that they read an interview about Frank and Ron commenting on how well, you know, Kelly and Billy were working together and how they had some pretty good chemistry. So, but we'll see. I don't know. I think right now he does have some really good chemistry with going with Becky right now. And it just seems like they bounce really well off of each other. They, like, work good next to each other. And but as for, they haven't really had too much interaction between him and Sam. Like, it's just Bailey, you know, like, in passing. Or, I mean, this Thanksgiving dinner was the first time I think Sam has really spent any time with Jake, or, well, Jason. So, it's like, we see, you know, Elizabeth interacting with Jason a lot, and there's obviously a connection there, but, you know, all we've really seen is just these brief moments between him and Sam, and so they haven't really had much of any conversations. You know, Liz was there the last time they talked, and of course she's at her house during dinner, so they haven't really had a moment by themselves to where they could talk and kind of, we can kind of see if they have any chemistry or not, you know?
Right.
So, I mean, we see Elizabeth and Jason talking all the time. I think that they really need to kind of engineer a thing between him and Sam, so that way, you know, we could kind of see how this is going to play out. Maybe at least get an idea of how this might play out.
Right. I agree.
So.
All right. Well, let's sweep through these other couple things, because we're passing 2 hours now, so we're going to have to wrap things up pretty soon. Let's talk about the Quartermain's Thanksgiving, which we kind of talked about that with Fluke, you know, showing up, Luke or Fluke, whoever the hell it is. As usual, the Quartermain's had pizza, which I think is a cute tradition. I like that they do that, especially as rich as they are. You know, they could easily have some big fancy, you know, Quartermain dinner for Thanksgiving. But they have pizza, and I think that's cute that they do that. Anything else special about the Quartermain dinner besides Fluke showing up?
Yeah. You have your pizza, and what else? I mean, just some general interaction between, you know, like Olivia showing up and, you know, coming to dinner, and then interaction between Lulu and, you know, Dante being there, and, you know, it's kind of like, it's just one episode, so there wasn't really a whole lot going on, but, you know, they always had their, something goes wrong, like Cook burns the turkey and they can't have Thanksgiving dinner, so they get pizza, or, you know, now at this time, Cook 2 got food poisoning, and they don't know what it is, you know, food poisoning. So it's really funny, and it's really cute, because it's so Quartermain. It's a tradition. So, you know, I'll be shocked if one day they actually successfully have a real Thanksgiving dinner.
Yeah, it's cute. I like that. I like that with them, too.
Yeah.
And then the Windermere Thanksgiving. There's a little touching moment. I love Spencer, of course. Spencer is so cute. And I love how Dr. O handled Spencer. He needs that in his life. I want Dr. O to move in with them and be grandma and whoop that ass, because I feel like, you know what I mean? I feel like Dr. O is like the mom and the discipline that he's always needed. You know what I mean? And I love Spencer exactly the way he is. But I think it's cute seeing how he listens to her and how she just kind of snaps him, you know, like snaps at him, like, you know, straighten up, boy. And he just kind of like, man, you know, but he kind of listens. You know, I think it's cute. You know,
yeah.
It'd be cute to have him have his mom, who's Brit.
Well, Dr. O is totally, like, intimidating, I'm sure, for a child.
Yeah. She plays that role like no other. But I think it'd be cute to see them have a happy family. Like, Dr. O live there, you know, have Brit being mom. You know, the prince being his prince normal self, boring self, and, you know, Dr. O being grandma and her little dealings with Spencer, I think that would be, you know, really cute. But I really like the moment where, you know, it's time for them to go eat, like I said earlier, and Britt kind of reached her hand out to her mom to come on and go eat, and then when they were walking, and then Nathan reached his hand out and took mom's arm too, hand too, and I thought that was really cute because they've never had a mother-son moment at all, and through it all, Dr. O, as rotten as she is, she loves her kids like nobody's business, and so I think that she really needed that moment, and I thought it was really cute, and I'm glad they had a little moment.
It's not going to last long because Faison's back and she's going to go like cuckoo in the head over Faison.
Well, you know how Britt is, though. Britt kind of, maybe Nathan will have his moments where he doesn't like his mom, but Britt has pretty much accepted her mom as she is. You know, she knows exactly what her mom is, and she's accepted her, and she still loves her, you know, either way. So she kind of just accepts her and is okay with her mom being the psychopath that she is.
Yeah, it's going to take Nathan a while to get there, but I don't know. I feel like if he finds out...
Well, Britt's a little demented herself, too, so she kind of gets it, you know.
I just think it's... Well, with her, it's not really, like, psychotic obsession. It's, you know, she just wants to be loved so much.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she's never had that warm, loving family. Like,
I love Dr. O. I think she's beautiful, too. And she's like a strange beauty. You know what I mean? Like, she's not, like so feminine pretty, but she's got, like, something about her. Like, she's got this, like, strange, like, foreign-type beauty. You know what I mean?
Exotic,
I don't know.
Exotic,
Yeah, exotic. Like, you couldn't really place where she was from. Now, she's usually wears blonde hair, but I love her black hair and her blue eyes. I think she's really a pretty woman,
and it
would be really cute to see her really have love with somebody. I would like that.
I agree with that. I think it would be really cute to have her find somebody and actually settle down, but she needs to move on from Faison because he's not doing her any favors.
He could care less about her. And she's actually pretty funny, too. Like, she's funny. And, you know, there's a lot of good things about her. She had a relationship. I could see her being just hilarious in a relationship and, you know, a hot mess, but, you know, but it being cute. So.
Yeah.
All right. So, yeah, that's about it. So at this time, we usually take a few minutes to have you guys, if you want to ask any more questions about what happened this last week on General Hospital, or if you want to comment on anything else, please go ahead and bring it up in the chat and we'll address it. Or you can call in at the number below. The number below is 1-724-444-7444. You will enter our call ID, which is 135-722-pound, and then you'll enter your PIN that you made when you created your account. Now, if for some reason that doesn't work, just hit 1-pound, and that'll bypass all of that and connect you right to us, and we'll answer any questions that you may have regarding the show, about General Hospital and Censored the group, about what happened last week on the show, or any other topics we've talked about that you want to still touch on. So we'll leave that up to you guys right now. I do want to bring up again the fundraiser, guys. Steve said that he's going to be donating again, so we're going to hold him to that. You guys all seen him say it in the group, so now he has to do it. So he's going to donate again to the fundraiser, so we thank him so much for that. And I just want to bring up to you guys once again, please take the time and donate even $5. I know it's the holidays and everybody has different things that they have to take care of, but if you could, you know, donate to our fundraiser, we'd be forever grateful. If you love the show and you love what we do and you love tuning in, please help us fulfill this this goal so that we can move the show to a better station that people can, effortlessly listen to the show and not have any problems with the volume going in and out or connecting with their mobile devices and all that good stuff. I believe they even have an app where you can listen to the radio shows through as well, where we want to move our station to. So if you guys could, even $5, we'd be forever grateful. We love you. You can find our fundraiser at gofundme.com/GH Uncensored. Okay?
Yeah.
So we would be forever eternally grateful. And let me give you guys the link. Okay, so Phyllis said... When Faison, Nathan, Britt, Dr. O walked into Nick's place, was sweet, even though sometimes they're weird. Phyllis said, Kimberly, this may be a little late time for a while. I'll be kicked out, I'll be homeless. So sorry, I do love it. Aw, you will not be homeless. I'll say prayers for you to make sure everything works out for you, Phyllis. Just keep your head up. And don't worry about us. I mean, there's 15,000 members in the group. I think we can make this goal sometime. You just worry about getting your stuff together. We got this. Okay?
Mm-hmm. And they'll be on and they'll be on YouTube, so you can listen to them.
What?
So, I said, and they'll be on YouTube, so whenever she comes back, she can listen to them on YouTube, the shows.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, you definitely, we put them on YouTube as well as on the homepage of this talk show page. You'll be able to catch all of our old shows on there. And good night, Terry. We love you, too. Thank you for tuning in and supporting General Hospital Uncensored, the radio show, as always. We love having you and having you participate. It looks like there's no more questions. It looks like everybody's done for the night. So we want to thank you guys all again for tuning in and supporting our show. We love doing this with you guys. You guys are a blast. There's never a dull moment. You guys, we'll see you guys again on, we're doing Wednesday, right? Yeah. We'll see you guys on Wednesday, 9 o'clock p.m., same place, different time, but we'll be doing the show, and we'll see you there. And if not, we'll see you in the group. Please spread the word and make sure you guys let people know in the group that you enjoy the radio show, so that way we can have other people come in and join us as well. A lot of people probably see the link, and they're probably like, what the hell is that? But they really don't know what it is. And maybe if you guys kind of tell people about it and, you know, give some feedback, people will get curious instead of just hearing us talk about it all the time. So if you love it and you support it, broadcast it. All right. Cheryl, anything you want to say?
No, I think I'm good. I guess I'll say goodbye.
Bye.
Bye. yeah, I just want to say, you know, just, I hope everyone had a good Thanksgiving, and I hope everyone is nice and fat from all that turkey, and I hope that you didn't have any crazy family drama like they do in General Hospital, and I'll see you guys on Wednesday.
Yeah, we'll talk to you guys on Wednesday, and we'll see you on Monday in the group. Remember, we always do the live feed during the show from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. where everybody gets in that one thread and talks about the show as it happens. So definitely catch us there. I won't be there because I'll probably be asleep because I'm a lazy bitch. But other than that, I'll see you guys around in the group. And we love you guys, and thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you guys. Bye.
Bye.